Money laundering is the process of making illegally acquired cash appear legitimate through dummy businesses or fraudulent financial transactions. Believe it or not, it was only criminalized in the Philippines in 2001 when the Anti-Money Laundering Act, or AMLA, was signed into law. AMLA empowered government to crack down on money laundering through an Anti-Money Laundering Council, or AMLAC, which has the power to weave through strict bank secrecy laws to investigate suspicious business transactions and activities. Suspicious transactions are defined by AMLA as anything involving ₱500,000 or more within one day, or any transaction regardless of amount that involves unidentified parties and or unusual deals. AMLAC also has the power to freeze assets and seize money and property deemed dirty from so-called covered institutions or individuals, which include banks, insurance and pre-need companies, and securities traders like stockbrokers. AMLAC wanted to amend AMLA to include casinos and real estate brokers in 2013, but they were left out. Once probable cause is established by any court, the AMLAC can investigate and freeze any assets without notice to the party being probed. Important to note, the AMLAC can only go after dirty money generated from specific crimes, listed as predicate crimes in the AMLA. There are 20 of these crimes all in all, some clear-cut, like drug trafficking and robbery. Others are blanket terms, like graft and corruption and terrorism. Human trafficking, illegal recruitment, and child abuse and pornography were added in 2013. Tax evasion is not included. AMLAC has three members: the Bangko Sentral ng Pilipinas, the Securities and Exchange Commission, and the Insurance Commission. The minimum penalty for money laundering is 3 million pesos. It can go to twice the value of any proven dirty asset. That comes with a prison sentence of 7 to 14 years. Individuals or companies that aid money laundering or fail to accurately report data requested by AMLAC also face penalties. Any public official or employee proven to be involved in this crime will be disqualified from office. Aside from Vice President Jejomar Binay, the AMLAC has investigated Marcos Trade Minister Roberto Ongpin and Senators Juan Ponce Enrile, Jinggoy Estrada, and Bong Revilla. Warren de Guzman, ABS-CBN News.